Well, hello and welcome back to module 4 of this e-learning course on how to program machines. In the last video, we were looking at getting started with app development, and I pointed you in the direction of one or two online services. And in this video, what we're going to be looking at is we're going to be expanding on that in more detail and looking at how we might use Microsoft Touch development to develop apps. And in order for us to do that, I'm going to hand over to a good friend of mine, Ray Chambers, who is a computing science teacher here in the UK. He's also the tallest teacher that I know, and he's going to be taking you through some of the reasons why he thinks touch development is an absolutely killer application for working with your students to develop apps for the phone, tablet, and the laptop. So, over to you, Ray.
I'm Ray Chambers. I'm the head of IT at Uppingham Community College in the Rutland area. It's the smallest county in the UK. I teach age 11 through to 16, and this year we've been very fortunate in that computer science has come into our school from September, and students are just loving it. So, I think the key feature that I like about Touch Develop is that you can use it on any device. It's across all platforms. You can go onto the Surface tablet, onto an Apple tablet, onto an Android tablet, and you can just load it up and start programming. So you could be on the way to the gas station with your parents, and you could be like programming your game and still continue the learning outside the classroom. And the great thing about it is once you've built that app, you can export it now and run it on any other device. And the students are just loving that they don't have to stop the learning in the classroom. They can take it anywhere with them. I think it needs to be portable, accessible. It needs to be engaging, because if you're going to give them something that's very, very kind of too heavy towards the text base as a kind of starting point, they're going to switch off. You need to give them something that they're gonna, that's a kind of happy medium. And I kind of like that about Touch Develop, because it's got text, but it's also got some blocks that help you with it as well. And there's a number of ways you can do it, depending on the age range you pitch that. Because if you were doing it with younger children, like say age 5 to 10, you might do something that's kind of, have you heard of Logo before? Like where you've got to maybe move a turtle around the screen and teach kind of repetition and iteration with them. So you can kind of do that activity with them. But as you're moving up towards the older students, they kind of really want to get into the gaming, and they can do the tutorials that are available there. And then moving on from that, what we've did in our school is we actually got our students to approach staff and ask them about what apps they would like. So it's more about it being applied, so they're kind of linking in with their other subjects. So we had one student went up to his history teacher and said, if you had an app that would help your lessons and help students be more engaged, what would it be? And he made this awesome app that was all about the trenches, so that you could find out more information and you're hitting the hotspots and finding all the technical terms. So that's a kind of project that you might do. Obviously, your problem solving links in heavily with your maths, your science, because you've kind of got to break down why you've got you might have this error popping up all the time, and you're like, why is it happening? And you've got to kind of take a step back and debug it and see, well, why is that happening? But also, it kind of lends itself to English, because in programming, it's not all about just staying in that block and making sure your code works. You've got to go out and speak to testers and speak to other students, so it helps them with their people skills. And I find that many of the students, after they've been doing a lot of these projects, have more confidence to speak to people outside the classroom.
Well, I hope you enjoyed listening to Ray there. I'm sure that you'll agree there's a huge amount of potential in using touch developments in the classroom, particularly as the outputs are so well tuned to cross-platform development. So that's it for this video. We'll see you in the next video, when we're going to be talking a little bit more about programming machines. In particular, we're going to be starting to have a little look at some simple robotics that can be used in the classroom. So we'll see you then.